Every great war has its heroes. I'm just curious what kind you'll be.
As of this moment, I declare the Inquisition reborn.
Okay, welcome back all to some more Dragon Age Inquisition. We're at Haven right now, just getting ready to head back to the war room. From there, we're going to travel to Val Royeaux for the main quest line. And go and confront or have... I think we're actually going to confront the Chantry there, or at least have words with them. Upon taking Mother Giselle's advice, you know, that to weaken their position, we simply need to sway some members, you know, bring doubt to their order that that the Inquisition, you know, get a few people on our side, you know, to believe that perhaps the Inquisition is worth following.
My scouts are posted on the ridges in case there's any trouble.
You know, so by perhaps presenting a little doubt in their position to a few of them, it weakens their overall, you know, their overall strength. Anyway, here it is. Address the Chantry in Val Royeaux. Cost me 4. Let's do it. Remaining Chantry clerics have declared the Inquisition heretical. Attempts to gather allies against the breach have been rebuffed. And at this moment, we could not step foot into the capital without being attacked by a mob or arrested. We must convince the Chantry to permit us entry into the city so we can show them the Herald of Undraste is not the monster they believe. Let's do it.
Having the Herald address the clerics is not a terrible idea.
You can't be serious.
Mother Giselle isn't wrong. At the moment, the Chantry's only strength is that they are united in opinion.
And we should ignore the danger to the Herald.
Let's ask her.
What can they do? It's just talk.
Don't underestimate the power of their words. An angry mob will do you in just as quickly as a blade.
I will go with her. Mother Giselle said she could provide us names. Use them.
But why? This is nothing but a...
What choice do we have, Liliana? Right now we can't approach anyone for help with the breach. Use what influence we have to call the clerics together. Once they are ready, we will see this through.
Okay. I guess we've read this. And let's confirm. And then when we get out of here, I mean, we won't spend a lot of time here. But I want to do a little shopping. I can inform you, for those of you that are unaware, hopefully I don't spoil this for y'all too much, but we will be picking up a new party member quite soon through this Val Royeaux experience. So hopefully that'll happen this episode.
The city still mourns.
Just a guess, Seeker, but I think they all know who we are.
Your skills of observation never fail to impress me, Varric.
My Lady Herald.
You're one of Leliana's people. What have you found?
The Chantry Mothers await you, but so do a great many Templars.
There are Templars here?
Not good.
People seem to think the Templars will protect them from the Inquisition. They're gathering on the other side of the market. I think that's where the Templars intend to meet you.
Only one thing to do, then.
You know, did I forget to... You know what I think I did? Just thinking to myself...
They wish to protect the people? From us?
Listen, Cassandra, we expected this.
Return to Haven. Someone will need to inform them if we are... delayed.
As you say, my lady.
Okay. She doesn't seem to be setting off for Haven. You know what I think I forgot to do? I had pulled those, actually, maybe I didn't. I don't know. I can't remember now at this point. I had, the one set of armor that I had for Cassandra. I pulled a piece. I think it was the heavy mail, or defender legs or something like that. I wanted to put them on the armor she was currently wearing. I don't think I actually did. So I'll have to look into that at some point. Maybe I'll do it between episodes if it just happens that we're back at Haven when this episode wraps. All right. So we've got some shops here, but I better get down to business here first. I'll tell you, it's real nice to be able to walk, you know, for the broadcast version of our arrival in Val Royeaux.
Stand wary, guardsman. The Inquisition is here, along with the Herald of Andraste.
Is this that dirty, rotten, rat scoundrel Vier? Is that his name? No, it's a different guy.
Templars will stand for us and help Val Royeaux return to mourning.
Didn't really have anything I could say with him. Here we go. You know, I think that little soul patch.
Of Val Royeaux, hear me. Together, we mourn our divine. Her naive and beautiful heart silenced by treachery. You wonder what will become of her murderer. Well, wonder no more.
Oh, we're still getting blamed. Behold, for this crap.
The so-called Herald of Andraste, claiming to rise where our beloved fell. We say this is a false prophet, a wicked kunari sent to subvert the Maker's word.
Let's try this one.
We came here in peace simply to talk, and this is what you do. I implore you, let us sit down together to deal with the real threat.
It's true. The Inquisition seeks only to end this madness before it is too late.
It is already too late. The Templars have returned to the Chantry. They will face this Inquisition, and the people will be safe once more.
Still yourself. She is beneath us.
Well, clearly, she's face first down in the dirt. Well, top the stage.
You're not here to deal with the Inquisition.
As if there were any reason to.
Lord Seeker Lucius, it's imperative that we speak with...
You will not address me.
Oh, damn.
Lord Seeker?
Creating a heretical movement. Raising up a puppet as Andraste's prophet. You should be ashamed. You should all be ashamed. The Templars failed no one when they left the Chantry to purge the mages. You are the ones who have failed. You who'd leash our righteous swords with doubt and fear. If you came to appeal to the Chantry, you are too late. The only destiny here that demands respect is mine.
Templars, one of your own commands the Inquisition's forces. Join us as he did.
You're a mage. Your ties are worthless. They are all made traitors just by being in your company.
But Lord Seeker, what if she really was sent by the Maker? What if...
You are called to a higher purpose. Do not question.
I will make the Templar Order a power that stands alone against the Void. We deserve recognition. Independence. You have shown me nothing, and the Inquisition less than nothing. Templars, Val Royeaux is unworthy of our protection. We march.
charming fellow, isn't he?
Has Lord Seeker Lucius gone mad?
Do you know him very well?
He took over the Seekers of Truth 2 years ago, after Lord Seeker Lambert's death. He was always a decent man, never given to ambition and grandstanding. This is very bizarre.
Do you think he can be reasoned with?
I hope so. If not him, there are surely others in the Order who don't feel as he does. Either way, we should first return to Haven and inform the others.
Okay. So the Templars really, just walked off the field, you know? Want nothing to do, leaving us to stand alone here. They stand united against the Inquisition, not even really recognizing us by the looks of things, and not offering the Chantry any sort of protection from the Inquisition. Let's have words here with Mother Havara, see if she's changed her tune now.
This victory must please you greatly, Seeker Cassandra.
We came here seeking only to speak with the Mothers. This is not our doing, but yours.
And you had no part in forcing our hand? Do not delude yourself. Now we have been shown up by our own Templars, in front of everyone. And my fellow clerics have scattered to the wind along with their convictions. Just tell me one thing. Are you the Maker's chosen, as so many claim?
I don't know what's possible any longer. I suppose I might be.
Maker, help us. What if we have erred? I suppose it is out of our hands now. We shall all see what the Maker plans in the days to come.
Let's see if we can pick up the pieces of this, perhaps sway the Chantry to our side. The Chantry.
So what happens now? Will the Chantry continue to denounce me?
We have already done so. And what good has it done us? Now it falls on us to select a new divine, if we can, and leave the next step to her.
Provided such a selection is even possible.
I truly don't know. Any revered mother who could have followed Justinia died at the Conclave. What becomes of us, and your Inquisition, is in the Maker's hands now.
It's not too late. The Chantry could still help us and come out on top.
If only that were true.
What's to stop you from trying?
We are not looking for a winning horse. We are simply trying to do the right thing.
Okay. Well, it didn't end quite as poorly as things began. With the revered mother here. Alright, at this point, I think what I need to do is get back to Haven. There's really nothing left for us here. Although, well, there is. I want to do a little shopping here.
The Templars left us to the mages. Chantry liars.
What's that? An arrow with a message?
A message from Red Jenny is what it said. The other thing, I never got to complete my thought. I'm thinking that this soul patch, this 5 o'clock shadow, whatever I'm calling it on Herza here, I think it's part of her Vitar. I just never really noticed it before. That's my best guess, you know. Anyway, favors for friends. Message is attached, written in a large flowing hand, and bordered with doodles. People say you're special, I want to help, and I can bring everyone. There's a baddie in Val Royeaux. I hear he wants to hurt you. Have a search for the red things in the market and the docks and around the cafe, and maybe you'll meet them first. Bring swords, friends of Red Jenny. And a poor drawing of the locations in the market is attached. Okay. Let's take a quick look at things here. Okay, friend of Red Jenny is right there. We've got a second one over on the docks. I guess this is probably the cafe. What is this exactly? I'm not really sure. Some sort of mission, though. I got a merchant. We've got a couple of merchants. I want to do a little shopping.
Wow! parties, the Grand get it all thinking. We must have a new divine. She will show us the way.
Stop in the shop here. Here we go. I just go right up to the rack, do a little buy and sell, and see what they actually have here. The Fade Walker staff, electricity, not interested. Dreamweaver, we're looking at fire damage. And I'll tell you, the Twisted Staff, it's electricity as well. The Dreamweaver, I'm digging the look of that much better than what I'm currently carrying with the Mind Leech. We get a boost to damage, boost to fire damage, plus 3 to Constitution. All right, if I can swap my my pieces over, I'll be quite pleased as well. I think I may grab that. Okay. What else do we have? Anything? The Superior Enchanter's Coat. Mage only, has to be level 7. She's not quite there. Level 6, unfortunately. What's Solus sitting at? He's level 6 right now. Got some new Vitars here. Oh my. Now I have to, I'd say I prefer that over the other one. That's kind of cool too. I don't know. You know, I'm going to go out on a, take a risk here. This is light armor. I can't actually, you know, and this kind of annoys me is that I can't actually see what it looks like until somebody is the appropriate level or whoever I'm trying to check it out for, you know. I think it'd probably be a smart choice to buy this. I've got the money. Why not? Oh, look at this. We've got some attachments here as well. Unfortunately, I don't know what they actually look like. Again, it's just, you want to know what it's going to look like. It's not just a bit, oh my god, I bought something here. The Enchanter Mail Arms. Well, I will grab the male legs as well. Why not? All right, let's get out of there. There is a couple of more merchants here. Be selling different items. I want to take a good look around. Oh, what's this now?
If I might have a moment of your time. Grand Enchanter Fiona?
Leader of the Mage Rebellion. Is it not dangerous for you to be here?
I heard of this gathering, and I wanted to see the fabled Herald of Andraste with my own eyes. If it's help with the breach you seek, perhaps you should look among your fellow mages.
I'm surprised the leader of the mages wasn't at the conclave.
Yes. You were supposed to be, and yet somehow you avoided death.
As did the Lord Seeker, you'll note. Both of us sent negotiators in our stead in case it was a trap. I won't pretend I'm not glad to live. I lost many dear friends that day. It disgusts me to think the Templars will get away with it. I'm hoping you won't let them.
So you think the Templars are responsible?
Why wouldn't she?
Lucius hardly seems broken up over his losses, if he's concerned about them at all. You heard him. You think he wouldn't happily kill the Divine to turn people against us? So yes, I think he did it. More than I think you did it, at any rate.
Well, that's good to know.
The mages weren't willing to talk to the Inquisition before.
Why now? Because now I've seen what you are. And I've seen the Chantry for what it is. Consider this an invitation to Redcliffe. Come, meet with the mage.
Excellent.
An alliance could help us both, after all. I hope to see you there. Au revoir, my Lady Herald.
Good.
Come. Let us return to Haven.
Not just yet, my dear. I'd like to follow up on this... this Red Jenny. And, I still want to do a little more shopping here. Or at least take a look around, you know. The Life Taker staff. Requirement level 13. That thing just looks just badass. Because I can't actually see it. Oh my god. The volcanic staff. Requirement level 9. Doesn't look like anybody can wield any of this. Oh yeah, this is a highly advanced store currently. Oh, here we go. No. Those are parts. Although, there might be something good here. 7 Constitution. I don't know. I wish, again, I'm not sure if it's actually popping up and I'm getting a good look at it. I didn't really notice any difference.
You are the Herald of Andraste, are you not? I have an invitation for you.
What is this now? First Enchanter Vivian, you are cordially invited to attend my salon held at the Chateau of Duc Bastien of Gislaine. Yours, Vivian de Fer, First Enchanter of Mosimard, Enchanter of the Imperial Court. Is that not who we were just talking to? I'm not sure. Actually, no. I think Vivian is a different enchantress. Different enchanter. Okay. It's time to get focused up on this Red Jenny affair. I've got a few different locations to track down here. I should potentially start with the docks. We'll move into the little cafe here, though. Something around here.
We should search the area.
My thoughts exactly, Cassandra.
Same old.
Alright, different simple script on the back of a stable report. Marked with red paint. Thank you, friends, for helping good Lady Caras. Saw those who asked about Harold enter third passage. Could not stay to see them exit. Third passage. I think that's what I need to commit to memory. Okay. Let's head out for the docks. The last location beyond the docks. The docks is down on this level. The last location, I think, is up a level here. A little bit harder to track down. Okay, key lifted from drunk swearing about Harold. Don't know what door I'm out, my debt is paid, so we've got the key. The third passage is what I'm looking for, by the sounds of it. And one more location. Upper level. I need to actually look around and see where the... I think that takes me up a level, that right there. Actually, there are a few different spots.
It's true.
Okay, the thing is way over here, though. I guess hitting up this stairwell or lift, probably my best choice. Okay, I guess right there. Am I on the right level here? Yeah, definitely. I can see it already. Okay, a scrap of parchment hastily torn from an ornate document, stuffed into its hiding space with a large red sock, and we are to obey well. We meet at Three Bells to discuss how best to serve the new way. Scrawled below in a misspelled script, Harold, go at time, praise Andrast. Taken together, the messages reveal a time, path, and key to a location on the world map. Good. Let's have a good look at it then. I think I have to actually exit. We'll go to the world map. No, that's what it is. The Imperial Enchanter. Okay, now this is Vivian Defer, the first Enchanter. Yeah, okay, so we've been called to her. The secluded courtyard, a friend of Red Jenny. In fact, I've never gone here, but I have a feeling that this may have something to do with getting yet another member of bringing another member into the ranks of the Inquisition as well. In fact, I think Vivian Defer is that other enchantress. I can't remember though. Anyway, I think I'm just gonna do a quick fast travel here. I think my work done is complete in Val Royeaux for the time being. Now, I should have the Dreamweaver staff on my back.
It's the Inquisition's barrel.
No.
Well,
good lord. All right, let's pull Hurza back here. I'd like to have Cassandra grab this guy. I'm gonna take control of Barret. Oh no. Oh, I thought things were freezing up there. There we go. Looking pretty good. Back to Varric. We have any archers up there on the balcony? Nothing. Ring velvet. Nice. Looks like some good cloth, you know. Anyway, firm round pommel. Take it. Doesn't look like there's anything else in the area. Here we go.
Harold of Andraste! How much did you expend to discover me? It must have weakened the Inquisition immeasurably.
I don't know who you are.
You don't fool me. I'm too important for this to be an accident. My efforts will survive in victories against you elsewhere.
Just say what?
What is that?
does she ever feed? Does she ever feed him?
But
that,
you heard me, right?
That arrow.
Just say what. Rich tits always try for more than they deserve. Blah blah blah.
Speaking of rich tits, goddamn.
So you followed the notes well enough. Glad to see you're well fit. Heard about your kind. Seeing's different. I mean, it's all good, isn't it? The important thing is you glow. You're the Herald thingy.
Mm-hmm. Some say that. Who might you be?
Some believe I'm the Herald of Andraste. But who are you, and what's this about?
No idea. I don't know this idiot from manners. My people just said the Inquisition should look at him.
Your people? Elves?
No. People. Name's Sarah. This is cover. Get round it. For the reinforcements. Don't worry. Someone tipped me their equipment shed.
they've got no breaches.
Why didn't you take their weapons?
Because no.
Okay, let's have a look here. We're getting swarmed. I mean, it's not a big fight that plays out in here, as I recall. Let's get Varric over there. I think Cassandra can probably grab that guy. And Solas can just continue to do what he's doing. I'd like to get Varric to actually... Oh, he did. He did use his ability. That's nice. Party's nearly over. Oh, he's done. He doesn't know what hit him with that. It's a nice little setting for the battle. I do enjoy it.
Friends really came through with that tip. No breaches. So, Herald of Andraste, you're a strange one. I'd like to join.
Okay, we'll see. First, how about we start with you making... Well, no, how about a real introduction?
How about we get to know each other first? You know, names and such.
One name. No, wait, two. It's... Well, it's like this. I sent you a note to look for hidden stuff by my friends. The Friends of Red Jenny. That's me. Well, I'm one. So is a fence in Montfort, some woman in Kirkwall. There were three in Starkhaven, brothers or something. It's just a name, yeah? It lets little people, friends, be part of something while they stick it to nobles they hate. So here, in your face, I'm Sarah. The Friends of Red Jenny are sort of out there. I use them to help you. Plus arrows.
So... You offering spies, then?
The Inquisition has spies already. Can you add to these professionals?
Here's how it is. You important people are up here, shoving your cods around. Blah, blah, I'll crush you, I'll crush you. Ooh, crush you. Then you've got cloaks and spy kings, like this tit. Or was he one of the little knives, all serious with his little knife? All those secrets, and what gave him up? Some houseboy who don't know shite, but knows a bad person when he sees one. So no, I'm not knifey shiv dark, all hidden. If you don't listen down here too, you risk your breeches. Like those guards? I stole their... Look, do you need people or not? I want to get everything back to normal. Like you.
You know, amazingly, I actually followed all of that, you know. Somehow I translated her lingo. Let's take another look here, see what else is... This seems interesting. I didn't understand this.
Back there, you wanted to know if I glowed. Why?
That's what you do, isn't it? You walked out of somewhere, and now you glow. Andraste's herald. True or not, it seemed like the easiest way to know it was you.
True or not?
Well, that's what they say on all. Look, don't get ahead, yeah? I want to help this... whatever it is. Inquisition.
Very well. All right, Sarah. I welcome you, yes, for now.
All right, Sarah. I can use you and your friends.
Yes! Getting good before you're too big to like. That'll keep your breeches where they should be. Plus extra breeches because I have all these... You have merchants who buy that pigeon. It's got to be worth something. Anyway, Haven. See you there, Herald. This will be grand.
I think if I remember right, she comes on board with a bag full of breeches as well. Anyway, so now I need to select the party. I think, well, I'll just stick with what I have currently. We're going to be heading back to Haven, so it's not going to be a big deal. And Sarah can, well, she can stick to the shadows and tail us back, I suppose. I think all of our work here is done. Ooh, reinforced shield. There it is, right here. Too many breaches. I don't even know what to do with that. I guess I'll sell it at the market back in town. Back in Haven. A little something extra here. There might be a little more loot out there, too. I'll have a good look. I think from here, yeah, it's just gonna be straight back to Haven now. Actually, no, there's more. I didn't even realize there was a baddie up there, but that's what it looks like. A little loot satchel left behind by somebody who got done in. Oh no, it's gold. She's a pile of gold. 80, not bad. Okay, so we've got our fifth member of, well, the active roster within the Inquisition. And I think I'm done here. I think I can probably just safely head back to the world map. Okay, so Grand Enchanter Fiona, leader of the Mage Rebellion, has offered an alliance with the Rebel Mages at Redcliffe. Return to Haven and discuss Fiona's offer with the advisors. And there's Val Royeaux, of course. Alright, well, I need to get back to Haven. And from here, I'm not sure where we go. I don't know if I want to jump right back to the Hinterlands. But I would like to tie up my work with Master Dennett, Horsemaster Dennett. Okay, since I'm right out here, there's a couple of things I do want to take care of really quickly.
Good day to you.
Shouldn't take too long.
Strong men around in case anything happens.
Okay. Let's see, want to look at staffs, give me my Mind Leech, and let me strip this down. We'll take the Dreamweaver. Now, do I want that? That's what I have to wonder. Yeah, I think so. Well, clearly, simply for the buffs. Magic and willpower. Staff looks okay.
Now, don't you worry about that sort of thing.
Okay, now the one thing I wanted to do, I wanted to check on anyway. Here we go, the Superior Enchantress. Enchanter coat. This will be good. We're really close to being able to don this. Very nice. What I wanted to do was head over to Cassandra. That's right. The heavy. And she's wearing this defender mail. And let's see. I do have defender coat legs. Oh, those seem to blend much better. There we go. Quite nice. I'll take it. I wish the color pattern was a little different. I'll tell you that that arm, the weapon and shield are certainly gleaming on her hip and back. Yes, digging it.
Looks fine.
Thank you, Hagrid, whatever his name is. I want to go in here real quickly. I just want to sell. The Mind Leech can go. Yeah, the Ferelden Captain Longsword can certainly go. I don't need that now. This reinforced shield, not gonna want it. I don't think, no, not at all. I could probably part with the Card of Code at this point, but I'm not going to. The Light Armor of the Dragon can, yeah, I think that can probably go. Okay. Did I have any more business down here? I don't really think so. So let's set off, head back towards the war table. Getting a little short on time here. I also had a couple of game crashes in there, in the mission hunting down Sarah. Hopefully I can weave it together so that it comes across somewhat seamlessly. At least that's what I'm hoping for. I've got some ideas. There were enough little cuts to various cinematic cutscenes that I should be okay.
It's good you've returned. We heard of your encounter.
You heard?
My agents in a city sent word ahead, of course.
It's a shame the Templars have abandoned their senses, as well as the capital.
At least we know how to approach the mages and Templars now.
Do we? Lord Seeker Lucius is not the man I remember.
True, he has taken the order somewhere, but to do what? My reports have been very odd.
We must look into it. I'm certain not everyone in the Order will support the Lord Seeker.
Or the Herald could simply go to meet the mages in Redcliffe instead.
You think the Mage Rebellion is more united? It could be 10 times worse.
Or you could stop bickering and make a decision.
I agree. We shouldn't discount Redcliffe. The mages may be worth the risk. They are powerful, Ambassador, but more desperate than you realize.
You think the invitation could be some kind of trap?
If some among the rebel mages were responsible for what happened at the Conclave,
the same could be said about the Templars.
True enough. Right now, I'm not certain we have enough influence to approach the Order safely.
Then the Inquisition needs agents in more places. That's something you can help with.
In the meantime, we should consider other options. There is one other matter. Several months ago, the Grey Wardens of Ferelden vanished. I sent word to those in Orlais, but they have also disappeared. Ordinarily, I wouldn't even consider the idea they're involved in all this, but the timing is curious. That does sound odd. I agree. The others have disregarded my suspicion, but I cannot ignore it. 2 days ago, my agents in the Hinterlands heard news of a Grey Warden by the name of Blackwall. If you have the opportunity, please seek him out. Perhaps he can put my mind at ease.
And if he can't?
Then there may be more going on than we thought.
Okay. So we've got another potential party member. Grey Warden Blackwall. Located in the Hinterlands somewhere. Influence is up, which could very well mean that I've got a second perk available. I also wanted to take a moment and when I next get the opportunity at the war table and see where my spies, those various, not my spies, but those various passive agents that I've collected along the way, like Ritz and Lord Barond, where they stand and the bonuses or the buffs that they're providing the Inquisition. Right now I really don't have much left to do. There's some sort of quest, out front of the building, out front of the chantry here. Maybe I'll go and check on that. I'm trying to think what I want to do next. I know I've got options. We've got a very swampy area. We've got the Storm Coast, and I could return to the Hinterlands. I'm not really sure. Huh. Probably gonna have to decide between episodes.
Excuse me. I've got a message for the Inquisition, but I'm having a hard time getting anyone to talk to me.
Who are you, soldier?
Comisius Aclasi with the Bull's Charges Mercenary Company. We mostly work out of Orlais and Navarra. We've got word of some Devinter mercenaries gathering out on the Storm Coast. My company commander, Iron Bull, offers the information for the charge. If you'd like to see what the Bull's Charges can do for the Inquisition, meet us there and watch us work.
Tell me about your leader.
What should I know about your commander?
Iron Bull? He's a canary like you. He's big, he's got the horns and all of it. He leads from the front, he pays well, and he's a lot smarter than the last bastard I worked for. Best of all, he's professional. We accept contracts with whoever makes the first real offer. You're the first time he's gone out of his way to pick a side.
Okay.
We'll consider your offer.
I appreciate it. We're the best you'll find. Come to the Storm Coast and you can see us in action.
Excellent. So Iron Bull on deck. Blackwall on deck. Vivian Defer on deck. Lots of options. How do I want to proceed? I'm not sure. I'll have to give it some thought. For the time being, I think I'm going to have to wrap this. I may be cutting this out a little bit short. I'm not sure. Let's jump into the... Actually, you know what I will do? Try and get it done here at the end of this episode so that people can cut out that aren't really interested in this sort of thing. I do have a few skill points that need to be assigned to the party, and I'm going to have a whole lot to dish out to Sarah. Let's see here. What do I want to do with Cassandra? Well, I think maybe going over to the Battlemaster side of things could be a good idea. What do we have here as far as passive attacks go? Hamstring, when you attack a target from behind, you leave them slowed. Crippling blows, you know how to take the fight out of your foes. Critical hits leave enemies weakened. Which... Damage reduction. So they'll do less damage with their assault, 15%. The effect also says it stacks. That could be good. Lasts for 10 seconds. Got a lot of passive abilities here. Combat roll. You dive and roll to where the battle needs you to be. It could be good to have this accessible. I think I may go with the hamstring here. Speed reduction 50%. I think that could be good because when I do take control of Cassandra, I do get a little, you know, I start going back and forth between enemies at times. I'm not sure. I could try and play it to try and come in behind people, circle around them as well. I have to keep it in mind if I decide to go with that. I think what I should base this choice on should be deep reserves, what the next passive ability is. You get your breath back faster than most when your stamina is very low. It regenerates more quickly. What's the other side here? Coup de glace. You deal more damage against enemies that are stunned or knocked down. Better them than you. Okay, we're going to go this way. So we'll do crippling blows here. Which will work out just great, you know. Take the fight out of her foes. Critical hits. You know, basically nerf the amount of damage that they're going to do for a little while anyway. All right. Out of there, head over Solus's. Well, actually, no, Saren. You can see how many points do we have with her? 7 that need to be assigned. For the time being, Solus. I need to get him some other sort of attack. Although, here we go. Do I have the ice wall available at this point? It is. Oh, that's quite nice. The wall of ice. You raise a wall of ice and keep enemies at bay. The one thing I wanted to try and veer away from, you know, after the encounters with that last rift with the Despair Demons and having Solus somewhat ineffective against them during that long, drawn-out battle, I was thinking about maybe trying to grab maybe the electricity, the basic electricity attack. I can't remember what it's called now. I should have remembered. Anyway, I think I will get this wall of ice. I can certainly think of uses for it. So let's grab that. Okay. Ah, Varric. let's see here. Let's get a little down and dirty with some traps or poisons. Looked like it hurt. Actually, the caltrops just increasing their usage. I've been going to them a little bit more often. The idea of running him through the battle to put him into a flanking position and dropping the caltrops en route certainly does appeal to me. It's just the fact that I have to be in control of him to pull it off. Otherwise, it's just a micromanaging nightmare, you know. Just a pain in the ass. Let's do it. I'll grab the caltrops. I've got secondary point with him, as I did have that amulet of power. Let's go back over to the bow here. See what I could perhaps grab. Alright, that passive ability, the pincushion, has been grabbed. Full draw, it takes a moment to line up the perfect shot, but it pays off with a devastating hit that bites even deeper against enemies who aren't injured yet. I don't know. I don't know if that really appeals to me here. The leaping shot is certainly an option. I think I'd rather buff his other abilities for the time being. Long shot now rips through every enemy along its path, doing bonus damage for each extra target it hits. Seems like that could be hard to take advantage of. I think I'd rather go this way. Chain reaction. Shrapnel from explosive shot fills the air, sets off deadly reactions that will do more damage the more enemies that are nearby. Let's do that. Okay, now it's just a matter of heading back Sarah's way and assigning her several points. Now, with her, I think I'm going to want the poison. Coat your weapons in a deadly toxin, making every attack poison enemies for a short time. Okay, but I don't know if I want that first on the list. I think the first thing I want with her will be the subterfuge, or no, the stealth. Step into the shadows, all but invisible to your enemies. Attacking from stealth gives you a damage bonus and brings you back to the enemy's attention. Dealing damage to enemies reduces the abilities. Cooldown time, we'll grab that. You live in the darkness. Entering stealth is now instant. Removes all debilitating effects on her. While in stealth, you can even pass through enemies without being detected. Let's grab that. Okay, let's go over to the poison. We'll grab the poison. Poison helps blades. Now let's see the second one. Infected wounds. Your poison helps your blades and arrows bite deeper. You do more damage with your weapon while poisoned. Weapons is active. Okay, well. Fighting dirty, all of your sunder and poison effects last longer as you make more potent toxins and uglier wounds. Alright, now let's go over to the bow for the time being with her. Get a couple of these. Death from above? No. First blood? I don't know. Long shot for sure. We'll grab that. We'll get that in there. Let's grab Fighting Dirty. And let's go back over to Subterfuge and see what she has here. Evasion. They can't hit what they can't see. Your deceptive fighting style gives you a chance to dodge enemy attacks, taking no damage. Easy to miss. Enemies are likely to overlook you in combat, much to their regret. This is especially true if you're flanking them. Let's grab that. Seems like a good choice. And still 1 point. Okay. Knockout powder. Oh, you throw a handful of dosed dust into an enemy's face, putting them to sleep for a short time. Let's grab it. All right, there we go all. Gonna wrap it. Don't want to do a big long ramble here as we've certainly run a little long. Appreciate you stopping by. Hope you're having a good time tuning in for this series. I know not many of you are watching it. Clearly the people that are still here are watching it, yes. I know there's not a lot of people, though, watching this series. I hope it grows over time, much the same way Skyrim did, although it's hard to compare the two games. But I'm glad to have the ones that, you know, those of you that are tuning in, stopping in regularly to check this out. And I hope you're enjoying it, you know. Till next time, remember why it hurts. Later.